Right now, here in Mission Control, I'm joined by Rob Adams, one of our inventory and stowage officers. Rob, first off, thanks for joining me here on console. Rob is, you know, one of our, like I said, inventory and stowage officers, so you're in charge of all the stuff. I think that's the easiest way to put it, right?
That's right. We're in charge of the stuff on station. ISO, or inventory stowage officer, obviously sort of describes what we do. We keep track of the inventory, and we keep track of the stowage, where all this, what the stuff is, and where it belongs, and where it should be. That kind of, that's the kind of data that we track.
And I mean, that's got to be pretty exhaustive. There's a lot of stuff on station. Just how do you guys, you know, keep track of everything?
We have a large database called the Inventory Management System, IMS, that keeps track of pretty much everything that has been launched to station since its inception, and we keep track of where that is. Based on what the crew tells us, mostly, we really don't have any data or telemetry coming down from the station that indicates where a particular item is at any given moment. We just have to rely on what we've told the crew and what the crew has told us.
So you got to work with the crew a lot. You got to make sure they're not lying. They know where everything is.
We do often look at downlink video and photos to double check if we see a serial number of a bag or an item or so and such and such. We check that against where we think it is in IMS and verify that that's what we saw in the picture.
Now, Rob, you're the lead ISO for Dragon.
That's correct.
It's the unmanned capsule that just knocked to the station a few weeks back. Delivering thousands of pounds of experiments and hardware to the station. Talk about some of the challenges, or some of the not so much challenges, the nicer things that you guys have seen working with the Dragon spacecraft.
Well, Dragon, the mission so far, at least from a cargo perspective, has been pretty smooth. The crew, the vehicle berthed on one day, and then the very next day they had unpacked everything, and we expected that to take a couple of days, so it was a very well put together vehicle, and the products we provided them, they told us back, were very clean, so they were able to unpack the vehicle much quicker than we anticipated, which has given us a little bit of cushion as far as packing the vehicle. As with any return vehicle, and I worked several shuttle flights as a transfer, which is similar, where we packed up the MPLM and the mid-deck, et cetera. There are always changes to the stuff coming down, and that's been the case here. So we have to be flexible and adjust our plans and products accordingly, and that's gone fairly smoothly as well. The crew is a little bit ahead as far as packing the vehicle. We have roughly half of it packed at this point. We have the aft and the starboard rack, finished off the starboard rack yesterday. So that leaves two racks left to go, and it'll be all packed and ready for reentry.
Okay. Now, with Dragon, some of the stuff that's been brought up is also returning back down. Has there been any special emphasis or anything special you guys have had to do to help the crew keep track of those items?
Most of those items are payloads. There is the one item, the cedra beds, which are being replaced on board. That's another item that, well, we're bringing up new ones and we're bringing down old ones, but they're coming up and down in the same bag. So we track that and make sure that the right parts get put into the bag and that the bag gets packed accordingly. And it does affect our planning on when we say the crew can pack that bag, specifically with the payloads, because they have payload operations that are going on throughout the dock, the berth time frame. And so we have to tell the crew after the payload operations to pack that bag up and put it back in Dragon. And that's typically, that's going to happen towards the end of the mission, towards hatch closure day. So that affects the products that we send up to the crew and how we choreograph everything, and we literally call it the choreography message.
Okay. Now, some of the items are experiments. Do you guys have a special system for differentiating for the crew, experiments, you know, crew supplies, things like that?
Not really. Not in our products. Mm-hmm. The payloads folks keep track of which is payloads and which is just system stuff. Sometimes, if it is payload dependent, we'll put in our list that this will be packed after payload procedures, such and such, and that indicates to the crew that they need to pack this after the payload operations are complete.
Okay. Well, like you said, you're about halfway packed. They didn't lose anything yet, did they?
Not yet, no.
Okay, nothing fell behind it.
Nothing has fallen behind a crack or gone into a ventilation duct or anything, a filter or anything like that. So we're good on that.
All right. Well, sounds great. Good luck getting the rest of Dragon packed and keeping track of everything floating around up there on station. Rob, thanks so much for being here with me today, giving a look at one of the many console positions here at the MCC. Thanks.
You bet. Thank you.